Time to play the game. It's all about the game, and how you play it. All about control, if you can take it. All about your stand, if you can play it. It's all about pain, and who's gonna make it? I am the game, you don't wanna play me.
Coming in the red corner, Frank Laborto, Victoria, Australia. Your timekeeper of the bell, Damien Membry. Your ringside physician, Dr. John Jory. Your recorder, Dean LaPass, representing the Melbourne Footy Club. Members of the board at ringside, Dr. Simon Hillman and two times Aussie champ and SEN 11-16 personality, Scott Brower. The official photographer, Werner Kitke-Kalen. World of Boxing magazine, your commentators are Gus Mercurio, Brian Membry. Come on. Thank you, Damien. Damien Membry, thank you. Okay, a lovely lady is carrying the numbers tonight. The lovely blonde lady is Claudia. Imogen is the brunette stepping into center ring. Men's gallery and centerfold. Imogen, number one. Wow. Here we go. Wow. Ladies and gentlemen, Murray Thompson, show 37, Friday Night Fights at Fort Knox. Howard Lee is my name, boxing is my business, and business is good. The Sting Show, six rounds of boxing, junior middleweight action, kicking off tonight's big program. Introducing first, in the blue corner, with manager coach, one of our great favorites, Mr. Tasanui. Ladies and gentlemen, this man from Bangkok in Thailand. He brings to Australia a record of 36 fights, 26 wins, 10 losses. Ladies and gentlemen, he's fought Sam Solomon, Chad Bennett, and Shannon Taylor. Tipping the scales at 70.20 kilograms. Wearing white trunks with a touch of green, gold, and blue. Would you welcome Thailand's Plai Sekta Sopakdi? And across the ring in the red corner, Maurice Schott from the north side gym with Adrian Chandler on board. Ladies and gentlemen, he lives in Reservoir via Glenroy. Aruf Tyler, six bouts, three wins, one draw, two losses at 69.60 kilograms, wearing white trunks, representing Australia. It's to be Frank, the Italian Stallion, Frank Laborto.
Okay, Brian.
Okay, Gus. Yeah.
Gus Mercurio and Brian Membry here commenting on this fight tonight, our first bout of the night at the Knox Netball Center on his 37th show, Murray Thompson's 37th show. We got
a great card tonight, Gus.
Yeah, it looks a good card. It looks a good card, starting off with Laborto and the Thai Sangwang Cha.
Beautiful jabbing by Laborto.
Yes, I remember his last fight that he had here. He didn't produce enough. He seemed to get into a rhythm which wasn't it wasn't that. He wasn't aggressive enough.
No.
And he tended to sit back a little bit. And he's going to have to fight this guy because this guy's going to
come forward. He's coming forward. That's right. But he's got a bit of a wallop. He got a handy punch.
Yeah, well, he's going to rely upon more than just the wallop. Of course, you've got to get that himself.
That jab is a good one, isn't it?
Gets in with that jab and follows with a good right hand to be the way to go with this guy. This guy does drop his left hand a bit. And his name is Plazdaka Wan Changwa.
Can we shorten that?
Yeah, Wang.
Wang.
Sing Wang. I don't want to be disrespectful to the guy, but Sing Wang and Laporto. Sing Wang is in the trunks with the red stripes down the side, and Laporto is all white.
He's got beautiful balance, Laporto. And I think it comes from the fact I've seen him skipping. He's a tremendous skipper.
Laporto,
is
he?
Yeah, got great balance. Yeah. Great balance. Has that body move.
Yeah. Those punches hurt. I mean, they build up, Brian, as you well know.
That's right. Another one. On the elbow. That one. Go to the body and you can get him in the head then, can't
right.
you?
That's what they say. Kill the body and the head dies, really. Yeah. Oh, good right hand. This guy is supposed to have had some 36 fights. He seems to know his way around in there. Whether he's had that many fights or not, it's hard to check on some of these guys.
I wouldn't think he'd be taking too much of that, though. He's coming back and up for more, though.
Yeah. Laporto's developed that jab better the last time I saw him.
He has worked it out a lot better.
Moving nicely. Right hand, just time that a little bit better. He would hit him on the chin with that right hand. I'd like to see what happens then.
I think Laporto was always better moving up.
Yeah. Well, yeah, with that forceful jab, I mean, that's what he should do. He's got a forceful jab. Move up on it. Frank Laporto leading that left jab. Jab is most important punch in boxing. We keep saying that because that's exactly what it is. Got to shorten that right hand a little bit.
In the noble art, it is probably the most classic punch.
Absolutely. There's a good punch to the body again to Laporte. Laporte, good punches to the body.
Not quite on the elbow, though, wasn't it?
Sang Wang Cha is coming back a little bit there. That's the round. That's the round. And, I think I got to give that to Laporte.
Oh, I think he's got that one, yeah.
So we got a round there for Laporte, and Sang Wang Cha seems to know what he's doing in there. We'll see. A lot of these guys come over, Brian, and we don't know what kind of condition they're in. They get off the plane, they're brought to the ring, and they fight. We don't know where they came from, really. The records are a bit hard to follow.
I think this little guy that's the trainer manager, he's pretty sort of straight on, though, isn't he?
Yeah.
He brings out a lot for Murray. And,
he seems to have an in with all the fighters over there to bring him out here. I see her. Matty Ropas is also one of the trainee judges over there. Matty Ropas is a very familiar fighter to a lot of fans. He's a very gutsy, tough fighter.
Actually, he did a bit of refereeing the other day.
Yeah, he's trying.
He's got a good voice, but...
Here we go, round two. He gave the first round to Laporte. Laporte with his stinging left jab and his body punches, which pulled that one out of the fire for him. Sang Wang Cha is an experienced campaigner, not getting hit too much. Seems to be that walking around is
he's
not going to do much good.
He's got to walk up a bit closer. Up a bit closer, Laporte. He's just hanging back a bit. Shorten the punches.
Yeah, he's got to shorten his punches a bit. I don't want him to lose that aggressive snap that he's had because, as I say,
lovely shot. Yeah. The uppercut.
The last time I saw him fight, he just didn't pull himself out of the rut that he was in, and he didn't make it because of lack of aggression. He's got the aggression tonight.
Oh, he has.
Good body punches. I think it's always a good idea to get these guys that traveled to fight, that come from a foreign country, work the body, see what they like
this,
down there.
What I like about this is I like to see guys fight up close.
Yeah.
Infighting is a thing that you don't see enough of.
Absolutely right, because the amateurs, they don't give any points.
They break them the moment they get up
close.
That's
right, so you don't get fighters learning how to infight. I noticed Sing Wang Cha got a very good right uppercut in close.
Yeah, good uppercut. He had a bit of power in that punch, I think, too, if it landed.
Ooh, nice right hand. And left hook.
Yeah.
Oh, Laporte, just a little shade off of that right hand.
Yeah.
I think he's doing the right thing, though, Brian.
He is indeed.
He's setting him up with the jab, putting him on the back foot, and then closing in.
Well, he's got to be busy. Keep busy. He's taking the lead. That's the whole point.
Yeah. Got to put him on the back foot.
Put him on the back foot. That's the only way, I think.
Now the guy's picking off his jab now. I think perhaps
a lot of the jabs are not sort of hitting. They're on the glove, but I mean it's stopping the other guy from coming up anyway.
Just hit him with the right hand, threw a right hand. I'd like to see Porte that left hook. I'd like to see Laporte feint that left jab and throw the right. Ooh,
yeah. That was one of the body.
Yeah.
That was a balk. That was a balk to the head.
Yeah, he balked that one and fired the left hook. He's doing the numbers. He's doing the numbers on this guy right now.
How long this guy can last, I don't know.
See, that's what we don't know where they come from. We don't know what they had to eat the day before yesterday. We don't know what he had to eat all last week, you know, coming from Thailand.
Frank's spraying him a bit now. He gets a bit untidy.
Yeah. But he's staying on top.
Oh, he's staying on top. That jab is not good enough. That's a better jab.
Yeah, yeah. He fainted that left hand a bit there.
Yeah. He telegraphed it too, I think.
Yeah, that's what he has to do. He has to.
Oh, there's a nice one. Yeah. Nice hook. That's the one.
Beautiful left
the hook is the one.
Got him hurt now.
Yeah, he got him hurt.
He hurt the left hook.
He hurt him there.
That's it.
Oh, yeah. Good call. One, two.
Well, no doubt.
No doubt about that one.
Yes. Sing Wang Cha is in trouble.
It wouldn't be far off a 10-8. Just probably just a bit under that.
Yeah, almost, but not quite. Come close to a 10-8.
Come close to a 10-8. I think 10-8 calls are very brave moves. You know, they're good moves because people are going to use it more, you know?
Yeah, yeah. We get
many fighters have lost fights because 10-8s haven't been given.
That's right. I like to use 10-8s, but the guy was only hit by two punches that hurt him, so it was a little bit asking a bit much to get
it. Was a bit, it was a bit, but it was on the borderline, you know.
Now, we'll see what happens because his corner, he's got Laporte's got a very good corner over there, of course.
Morris shot.
That's right.
Yeah.
And the other guy, the tall guy, Gallagher. Not Gallagher. Anyway.
Here we go. We're back to business.
He will tell him what to do. This is round three.
Of a six-rounder.
Laporte was well on top in that round, very close to perhaps a 10-8 round. See if he continues that left hook and see if the other guy can protect against it.
Another round like this and could be a stoppage coming up. I don't know. That's good possibilities.
Right hand got through. Laporte is doing a good job. He's much more aggressive this time. He's fighting the right fight, which is the main thing.
He is.
Sang Wang Cha, I don't know what he can...
Oh, that's a good one.
Yeah.
But he telegraphed it, didn't he?
He's going to be in trouble because he's getting Laporte's landing punch. As you said in the opening, Laporte's got a bit of a punch to him.
Yeah, he got a wallop. He's getting on top now. This is just getting a bit difficult now.
The other guy's slowing up a little bit, too.
Yeah. Shorten him up.
A bit low, but it was that. Now's the time boxing is a thinking game. Now's the time for Laporte to step back and think what he's going to do.
Yep. Instead of just blindly
That's
throwing
right.
punches. But
his corner is yelling for an uppercut.
He just seems to lack the power to do it now.
He's following his corner's. He's following his corner's.
That's the one. That left
advice.
That left hook is the one.
Bryce Braithwaite was watching. The referee is watching very close.
Yeah. It's not far off it. It's one or two more, and I reckon that's it.
Yeah, that's it.
That's it.
Oh, he's going to count him. He's going to give him a count.
Yeah.
He's close to a stoppage. If the guy wouldn't have gone down, I think he would have stopped it.
Yeah.
Okay.
He's going to call him in. One more and there should be a stoppage, I think.
If he gets cornered like that again, I don't think Bryce Braithwaite will let this go on. Bert was it.
Was a low one again. He's a bit sloppy with it.
He's going to call up about that low punch, yeah.
Yeah, good one.
You don't want to lose this round now because he's got a 10-8 round right now.
Oh, he's got a 10-8 now, I'd say.
He doesn't want to get a low punch violation. Don't let this guy come back. That's the worst thing you can do is get the guy hurt and let him come back.
Yeah. It's a question of fitness now. How fit is Frankie?
Yeah. I think Laporte should be fitter than the other guy. Mouthguard came out.
Mouthguard out.
Yeah.
I used to call him Frankie Goes to Hollywood. I don't know why, but he should have fitted that out. Well, I'll give that a 10-8, I think.
10-8, yeah. Yeah, that's got to be a 10-8. Those cheap mouth guards that they use, too, you know. They're just a dime store mouth guards that they buy cheaply in the chemist or the supermarket, put it in hot water, and let it set in their teeth. They're not made for the mouth.
If you're going to get a mouth guard, get a quality.
Absolutely. It's so important. So important.
But I think they should go to a proper dentist.
Absolutely.
Proper practitioner.
Absolutely, because you lock your jaw in place, and that's important. Your jaw is loose. Yeah. You're going to get hurt.
Yeah. Get a good one, you got it for life. It'll fit you for life.
I like the double mouth guard that they're coming up with. I think that's a very, very good innovation.
What do you call it?
Double mouth guard.
Oh, the double, yeah. Well, that's a medical aspect.
Yeah.
They use
that, don't they? Here we go. We're going into the fourth round. Laporte is well on top. I've got him ahead by 4 points at this stage. Sing Wang Cha is getting hurt.
That left hook is the danger punch for him. Oddly enough, it's his leading punch.
Yeah.
You think the right hand would be his big punch, which he gets through.
He wants to pick his body shots.
Oh,
it's a bit better.
Look at that rip.
And he's leaving himself open to that left hook from the other guy, too. Wants to be careful.
That's good shouldering.
Oh, yeah, that's it.
This is almost double now.
Yeah, that's it.
Good girl.
Yeah.
But we don't need to see too many getting hurt.
No. Nah. No, a good stoppage. A good stoppage.
Official time, 40 seconds into round four. Your referee in charge of the action, Bryce Birtwistle, Scott the contest. To be frank, your winner, Frank Laporte. Good sportsmanship there, shown by both guys. Frank, come across. Got on your album. Frank, your punching power tonight, since you've joined Maurice Schott and Adrian and all the big guns at Northside, you threw some big bombs tonight.
Yeah, I managed to land some, and I think that got him. But he put up a good fight for four rounds, whatever it was. But I started to feel it. But all the best to him, and thanks a lot. But I want to thank my coach, Maurice Schott, Paul, all the boys in the corner, all the boys that come out of the gym and support me, and everybody that came here to support me tonight.
Well done. Frank Laporte, a big winner tonight, his best win of his professional career. Mike Ravelli from the Gold Coast coming on down. Mike Ravetti. Give a warm welcome from the Gold Coast, returning to Melbourne. The Heat, Heath Ellis. Yeah.
Ladies and gentlemen, six rounds of international boxing in the welterweight division. Murray Thompson, Funners Factory, Fort Knox, Friday Night Fights. Introducing first in the red corner with Chubby McAvoy, joined by Les Wilson. Born in New Plymouth, New Zealand. Now resident Varsity Lakes, Robina on the Gold Coast. Ladies and gentlemen, in amateur boxing, a national and Queensland state amateur champion. Coming to Melbourne for the second time in professional boxing. He was here at the Rumble on the Wharf, where he stopped Paul Thornycroft on October the 2nd. Ladies and gentlemen, at 63.90 kilograms, eight professional fights, two wins, wearing red trunks with white trim. Would you welcome Mike Mad Dog Rivetti. Rivetti. And in the blue corner with Keith Ellis Sr., Neil Ellis, joining Greg Grogan, Kingsbury Gymnasium, from Greenvale in Melbourne's northwestern suburbs. He was a six times Victorian amateur champion, a national amateur champion. Ladies and gentlemen, at 64.80 kilograms, made a sparkling debut here on Fox Sport July 28th, wearing black trunks with white tassels, with Heath on the front. Ladies and gentlemen, hot to trot, Heath the Heat Ellis. Your referee in charge of the action, Malcolm Mulder, judges at ringside. Ah, Joe Mann, Andrew Campbell, and Bryce Birdwhistle. Here we go. Six rounds of boxing.
Welcome to center ring. Shake hands now. You've had your instructions. I want a good, clean fight. May the best man win. Shake hands. Good luck.
Well, Brian, we'll just see how Heath handles this. The first fight he had here, he came out like a whirlwind.
That's right. There was no jabbing.
No thinking, nothing.
No jabbing or anything.
Nothing, just whirlwind.
From the leading newspapers, round one.
Okay, round one. Scheduled for...
Six rounds.
Six three-minute rounds. Six three-minute rounds. He's controlled his aggression this time. He's come out with a bit of thinking this time.
Nice shot to the body.
Good right hand. Last time he was all over his opponent. He just a nervous energy buildup. This time he's thinking. That's Ellis I'm talking about.
That's correct, yeah.
In the black trunks with the white trim. I think sometimes, Brian, they dress these kids up in such a way that they think that they're a champion now. They put a lot of load on their shoulders.
Yeah,
you know what I mean?
A lot of load, that's right.
Good left hook, good left hook.
Good clean left hook.
Heath Ellis.
That was economical, what he's done so far.
Yeah.
He hasn't.
A little bit of a slap at that right hand, I thought.
Yeah.
He's thinking his way through this, I think. That's good. Trying to figure the guy out. Not going bull at a gate.
It's not going bull at a gate, but... Oh, nice.
Oh, I don't like the way he went back from there. He went back with his head up in the air. I don't like that much, but that's experience. He didn't get hit. Got to hold his hands up. Hands up, head down.
That was a nice damage, that one.
Yeah,
bit of damage in that one. That was his brother or his uncle, wasn't it?
Uncle, yes, it was.
The great body rip.
Yeah, a little bit of slap at that right hand, Brian. It's twice now I saw that.
Yeah. He has his own unique style, really.
Yeah.
There's no jab or nothing. It's a different style, isn't it?
That's one thing a fighter's got to do, is make the other guy miss and make him pay for it.
That's right. He's just nudging this round first.
Yeah, he's just nudging. Nothing spectacular, but he is he's winning it.
But actually, I prefer to see him fight like this, not run everywhere, you know?
Yeah. He's got to do this as a learning experience.
It's, you know, if it goes three or four or five rounds, it'll be good. The further it goes.
Well, I got to give him that round.
Yeah, he got that round.
That's Claudia. Yes, he thought his way through that. He didn't go wild. The other kid is a pretty tough kid. I wonder what's going to happen this round, because he should have figured him out, I think, in that first round. He should have got a bit now, so what to do with this guy.
You think so? But I think the main factor with him has been in his amateur career, and I've watched him, he just doesn't seem to want to listen to the corner.
Ah, yeah.
Now,
okay.
It's important he does take good advice, you know?
Absolutely. Corners, you got to listen to the corner.
And I think that's been his detriment in the amateurs, you know? But
well, we're coming up for round two.
He worked very well in that round.
Round two, six rounds, 3 minutes each. Heath Ellis in the black trunks with the white trim, and the boy in red and white is Mikhail Rivette from up Queensland way. A bit of aggression from Rivette.
Yeah, that's the first jab I've seen him throw.
Yeah, another one. Got another one in there too.
Another one. That is a call, isn't it?
Looks pretty cool.
He looks good.
That's nice.
That's a good mess.
Yeah, he worked that nicely.
Oh, yeah. A bit
good
of
body punch.
Glove, ain't
that? That was like, here, take that. It's not developing as I thought it might, to tell you the truth, but those are nice little thinking
things. Yeah, lovely double. Sure.
Dude, that's classy work. That gives him the edge.
That was
see?
Class. That
gives
was
him
class.
The edge on the round. Things like that.
Yeah. That's
good
beautiful
punch.
Stuff.
At least he is working the body, something beginning fighters don't do enough of. By that I mean new fighters, you know, inexperienced fighters. They should learn to work the body. Good.
That's
right
a nice shot
to
the head.
Yeah. He's working this guy pretty well,
oh,
I think.
Oh, doing well this round. I think he's shaking the other guy's confidence a bit.
I think he has too. He gets hit and hurt.
When you get hit and hurt, it's a different thing, isn't it?
Yeah. You get a little bit gun shy, don't you?
Yeah, my word.
Well, they call him Mad Dog, and the other guy went crazy in his first fight. Wanted maybe they both go crazy here.
Mad
shortly.
Dog, remember Mad Dog?
Yeah, Mad Dog.
I refereed his first pro.
Yeah, I refereed him a few times. Yeah. Tony Miller.
I threatened to ban him one night.
Yeah.
The guy was down on the floor and he wanted to hit him.
Oh, yes.
Well, that was a good one. He was open for that.
I always thought he was going to switch the softball there for a minute.
Where's the softball connection?
I thought that he was going to do that there for a minute. He always, but he didn't.
Oh, that's a nice jab. Yeah. That is a nice
I think
he
just got the edge in this round, Brian.
Oh, he's got the round, there's no question. He's assertive. He's just gone off a little bit the last 30 seconds, but...
That's a slap of the right hand, Brian. That's three times
he's
now.
He's inclined
that's a slap
to do
of the right hand.
Yeah.
Round two. Well, I gotta give the kid the round, I'm afraid. It's not a decisive round, but I think he just showed enough class that the round's gotta go to him.
Yep.
I'd like to see him now.
That's
show us what he's learned in those two rounds. Jab, straight right hand, thus slapping with it. And concentrate the body attack and then switch to the head. Not just hit to the body, move out. Concentrate to the body, then switch to the head. You know, bang, 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 body, switch upstairs.
Yeah, I think he's just got to sort of concentrate now and take it right up to him. Put it on.
Got to do that. Got to do that. You got to put him on that back foot.
He's got the chance now in this fight to take over.
From this point on, he's going to have to. And I think they're going to have a big problem with that right hand. Here we go. This is round three of this six-round fight. Keith Ellis in the black out of the blue corner. And Mikhail Revit out of the red corner with the red trunks. He's not a pushover, that's for sure.
He never was going to be.
He keeps working, you see, now.
Now he's going for it now. It'll be full on.
He keeps trying to do something, Rivati.
He does, and actually up to this point, he's holding around.
Yes, he is. Yes, I like that, when he tries to do something all the time.
Yeah, he doesn't want to hold. He punches up
yeah.
close.
The other guy missed.
Yeah.
You know, Mikhail Rivetti, is it Rivette they pronounce that?
Rivette.
He's not far off with the ability to take this round and even to take the fight.
Oh, well, he's got it so far in my book. Two beautiful body shots. Oh, return. Oh, that's counterbalanced that, though, isn't it?
Yeah.
It can change in a flash.
Yeah. Sort of evened it up at that point.
Oh, that's
see how
right.
we go from here. I don't think Heath is doing enough.
No, he's not.
Not doing enough.
But I think he's doing it a bit easy.